Do you know why loop diuretics cause hypokalemia? Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will see mechanism behind hypokalemia by not only loop diuretics, but other diuretics also. Let's get started. First, relevant physiology. This is nephron, this is its collecting duct, and this is principal cell. Principal cells have epithelial sodium channel and potassium channels at the apical membrane and sodium-potassium pump at the basolateral membrane. And here we have sodium in the lumen. Yeah, it's sodium. We will come to potassium just in a minute. Sodium concentration inside the cell is lower than that in the lumen. This gradient drives the diffusion of sodium into the cell through epithelial sodium channels. From cell, the sodium is actively pumped out into the interstitium by sodium-potassium ATPase pump. This extrusion maintains low intracellular sodium concentration for continuous sodium entry at apical membrane. Entry of positively charged sodium into the cell makes the lumen electron negative. And this brings us to potassium. It's a positively charged ion. So this negative charging of the lumen drives secretion of potassium from cell into the lumen. Then this potassium is lost in urine. Thus, the more the sodium enters into the cell, the more the lumen gets negative and the more the potassium is secreted. Now let's bring in loop diuretics. It works at ascending limb of loop of Henle. Here sodium is reabsorbed by sodium potassium 2 chloride cotransporter. Now loop diuretics inhibit this cotransporter as we have seen in video of its mechanism of action. This inhibition leads to decreased sodium reabsorption at loop of Henle. So more sodium reaches to collecting duct. So more of it enters into the cell and makes the lumen more electronegative. And this in turn increases potassium secretion. Finally, increased potassium loss causes hypokalemia. This is how loop diuretics cause hypokalemia. The same mechanism applies to all the diuretics that increase sodium load reaching the collecting duct. For example, thiazide diuretics. They inhibit sodium reabsorption at distal tubule. This also increases sodium load reaching the collecting duct and eventually hypokalemia. Same applies to carbonic anhydrase inhibitors as well. They work at proximal tubule. I hope it's clear now. In short, you can remember, all the diuretics working proximal to collecting duct cause hypokalemia by increasing exchange of sodium with potassium at collecting duct. That's it, friends. If you found this video helpful, please share it with your friends too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.